nakuha ang table natin. Yung mga talong po natin sa kanya, i-rect naman natin. Tapos yung mga tapos sa ikod, pakilisan na muna natin makaubo. Okay, thank you.
And
iwasan
natin pala na lumabas-labas habang
and then it's got some other speakers. Okay? So, yes? Right. Okay, so once again, let's welcome Dr. Bartolome Bautista. Let's give him a round of applause.
The topic that I will present before you is a classical example of how information technology is applied to disaster mitigation. The title is Development of a Rapid Earthquake Knowledge Assessment System in the Philippines for the local government units or LGUs. So this is basically an earthquake hazard simulation software which we distribute to the local government units so that they can have a tool for mainstreaming earthquake hazards and other natural hazards in their land use and development activities. There are several authors who help us in developing this tool. I won't be enumerating much on this. What you see in this slide is that we have Dr. Rinpoche Bunbaya, advisor in developing this tool. And then recently, our new director, Dr. Renato Silver, is in continuing the development of this tool. This will be the outline in my presentation. We will discuss a little bit about the problems of the Philippines for natural hazards. Then the reason why we have high problem vulnerability. Then we'll also discuss the methodology for vulnerability assessment. And then a little bit explanation about the Ready project. Ready project is a new project which is funded by the UNDP. Through the Australian government aid for international development. And we use this project in order to propagate awareness to the local government. And then I will explain how we develop weapons. And then the training that we are providing to the local government is to do the capacity. And then our plan in the future for developing the tool. Then I will provide some training. The Philippines is located in geographically located in a region which makes us very vulnerable or highly prone to natural hazards. We are located along in zone number 2, large converging plate and as such, it makes us very prone to earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. We are also located along Typhoon Belt. This makes prone to typhoons, flash floods, previous landslides, storm surges. So, mainly we have to hold the house and kind of houses, including mountain houses. And there are several reasons why we are highly vulnerable. One is that we have a rapid development and uncontrolled population growth. And then lack of proper land use and development plans. Very long implementation of the building codes and other regulations that can reduce this. Lack of contingency and emergency plans. So all of the above results from the lack of understanding about the process and risk of the local government position. So the solution to this is to train, to educate, train and build the capacities of the local government units. The idea about reference of consumers as a result of our experience during the occurrence of a big earthquake in the zone July 16, 1990. A typical situation in an arts office in the earthquake of ours results in a breakdown of communication, disruption of power supplies, delivering brownouts and isolation of affected areas to open up the building, so you won't be able to pass through the roads network. And then blocking the road networks by landslide. So many cities will be isolated. There won't be any access in the country. You won't be able to obtain information on how serious cities were affected. So much of the needed information is available, which are vital for making quick decisions. But by the disaster managers, that they can concentrate and focus the leader resources on the government for rescue and relief operations. So there is a need for a tool that can simulate the hazards and then tell us where the severely affected areas are located. So our target users for the software are the civil defense officials, software managers and responders, rescue and medical groups, and then USB and disseminate information with the public. And then we have target users too. These are the local executives of the mayors, provincial, municipal body officers, building officials, and municipal workers. Our objective here is to provide deeper understanding and appreciation of the earthquake hazards and risks, in order to motivate them to receive this planning and coordination with effective disaster prevention. This is a snapshot of the introduction page of the webinar. It shows here that it is still in version 1. At this moment, we are already in version 2. There are more features that have been put up in the version 2 of the software. So, the software is actually earthquake hazard simulation tool. It has a risk database built in on the system. And the main objective is to simulate the hazard immediately after a big earthquake and provide information. It was developed by PeopleWorks in 2003-2004 and the Department of Science and Technology is a big project. And then we start disseminating the tool to the local government units in 2006. Software can basically do seismic hazard assessments of ground shaking, big fracturing, landslides, and tsunamis. Then plant element of risk, as population centers, buildings, bridges, lifelines, critical facilities, hospitals, fire stations, and other important facilities that we need to evaluate immediately after the disaster. Other capabilities of RedDAS can sort of take a faster and new size system for qualitative risk database point query, then we can have to make a performance and potential. And also, the three other static algorithms allows users to build their own based on the during the development stage, there were several requirements that we needed to do this because it is not only a 2-year project. We were working on operational direction. And then our targeted users are local government. So we need to satisfy this requirement, which will be fast. So to be fast, we need to use simple algorithms. Then we need to pre-process most of the database and then we need to do the tool. Then as I mentioned, on the telemetry these are busy people and they don't take much time to study and to get the type of topic. So we need to make a very proud test team. And to do this, we need to make it simple and very effective, and then make it highly intuitive. And then we intend to distribute it widely. There are several matter of regulation to very similar to that. But all of them are actually GIS. So you need to buy expensive GIS systems in order to run this. But in red up, we try to avoid the use of commercial
finance.
In this video, we will also implement software without worrying about the license. And then it should run
simple and
easy. The level of mapping is able to be the mapping of the original and the local state. And we are not professional programmers, so we don't have professional programmers. So we just use a very simple programming tool, which is to produce a convenient graphic interface. Do the database searching and processing, process the data before building and writing the CMC. And then the smart mapping tool or CMC is a freeware developed by the system. Actually, the hard system is being used in generating fancy and sophisticated maps that are using data. And initially, we are using text database, but later, because Ghostscript produces PostScript, so Windows, Visual Basic cannot be accessed JSON or bitmap, so we need this tool freeware to convert to data format with image format that Visual Basic can understand. And this is a schematic diagram showing the process getting into the system. The big boxes are the parameters, input parameters to that are suggested. The earthquake magnitude, hypocentral data, and then quantum mechanism for the earthquake. Then you can start processing. This is the green boxes here are the processes that is taking place inside that. And then the blue boxes are the pre-built database. These are susceptibility maps or susceptibility data. These are pre-computed and they have built-in inside the database of programs. So you can produce different water sums, tsunami, high sedimentation map, liquefaction map, big drum acceleration map, for the density map, land flight potential map, and then there is also the risk database inside Red Hat. Building, building, lifetime, dams, power plants, population, so on and so forth. And these are inputted to the vulnerability assessment process and then to come up with vulnerability. This is the process for estimating the rotating hazard. You just said empirical procedures to reduce the peak ground acceleration, and then this site response or ground configuration information is obtained from a geologic map and then this road map. And then we also produce the amplification data, which is a master file and that is built into the system. And whenever there is an earthquake, we produce the peak ground acceleration map and we multiply it with the amplification information to come up to the intensive final intensive map. Considers the effect of local geology. And for the two other hazards, which are the liquefaction and landslide, we need to develop and susceptibility information and have them built inside the river. And these are the procedures that we produce them. We use systematic information such as slope, geology, soil distribution, geomorphology, apply influencing factors, and then sum them up around the story. Thematic map, and then calibrate the thematic map using historical earthquake, track of historical earthquake, this is Whenever there is an earthquake, we produce the intensity map, and then after that we go, the program will go into sensitivity file, and then what the program will be is compare the two maps and then subtract the two maps, so that the difference it will produce another raster file is actually the difference between the thick graph acceleration map and the critical acceleration map. And depending on the distance, we'll inform you where the areas which have higher potential for higher diffraction and chance light. Okay. This is an example after producing the intensity function, the diffraction map, and the scale map, the expansion, the amount of seeds, and then the landslide. And for tsunami, one of the procedures is to do modeling. But modeling is a highly computer intensive operation. To simulate the tsunami, it takes several hours to come up with the model. So my opinion is, during five times we do simulation, and then we will put the results in the computer. So whenever there is a big earthquake, we just try to compare the nearest model in the database and put this out, and then this one we display. This one will take time to do, but now we are still producing the database. But in RADAS, there is another procedure which is just a procedure. So we just use this equation to compute the empirical amplitude of the dynamic position. So we compute the amplitude of the wave height and also the arrival from the line to the coastline using this equation. And this is an example of the tsunami hazard. It shows you the arrival time and amplitude of the tsunami of predator points. This circle still shows you the point where the tsunami arrival and tsunami amplitude is computed. And inside the lid or radar, there are also other lids that are built in. One of the information is a 1x1 minute digital imagery, so you can have an idea of the topography and the topography under the ocean. And then a 3x3 second digitalization model from the Antarctic. And then it can also host vector data, such as photo lines, optics, meters, digital boundaries. Which was provided by Maria, the National Information Administration. And then one of the important databases that RADAS should contain a rich database. So in this map, we just show some of the information that we can display in RADAS and overlay with a hazard map. So we need to know. In disaster management, we need to know where the public schools are, because these are used for evacuation. We need to know how many people, how big is the compound of the school, how many evacuees can accommodate, other comfort rooms or other amenities, and other families that are being evacuated people. And then hospitals, we need to know the capacity, what are the specializations to hospitalize, where is the location. And then fire stations, for putting up the police station, other government offices, especially those which are involved in the national. And we need to plug them in the hazard map so that we know which hospitals are affected, which schools are affected, which schools are still available for the evacuation. So these are very important information that disaster managers need during times of emergency. And then, through the RADI project, actually RADI is an operating, short operating for hazard hunting and assessment for effective community disaster risk management. And it has three components. One of them is the biological identification and risk assessment. Second is the capacity building. And then the midstream of disaster risk reduction and development planning process. So the Bhutta is the number one component produces the hazard map. And then the second component of capacity building here in IEC is done on also for the community and simulate the hazard map that have been created in unemployment. So component three is the midstreaming of the hazard map into the hazard planning. We use the red as tool that we use to introduce the hazard maps to the local government building. And these are some examples of the very much process. And we also have put into the web solutions. So weather can be still on this map. And then a typical 5-day weather training module contains this all these activities. But the most important of them is the mainstream assessment of the local development and land use planning. And then the other activities are just lecture about the hazards, tips we talk about giving information from people with different hazards and how they can respond to the hazards. And then there is some lecture photo on how to use the software and how to build their database. And then this is the typical session during the mainstream activity. The Redis trainer also has a background in land use planning facility design. Planners are asked to identify the hazard in respective municipalities. Then they are asked to identify current land use, they are asked to offer solutions. And during planner session, they start with the other participants. About their ideas and how to solve all the problems. And then in the process, they get a complete understanding of their provinces, municipalities, hazards, and possible solutions to those problems, how it will affect their land use. And then position their mind, we inform them about the earthquakes and support in their area. We talk about the and we inform them what happened in the past, after the impact of this year historical earthquake, and also the recent earthquakes in the world, so that one example is the United earthquakes, and what can the earthquake do? So this one tells you the severity of the problem. What will happen today when the population is very small? Today, we have a higher population. This historical earthquake will happen today in the impact of the population. These are some of the provinces found in And then the responsibility of the local government unit is to build their own database and share this with the provincial government. And then the provincial government will collect all this database and then share it to the national government. So this is the concept which will eventually lead to the good time where we can build the best sufficient information that we can use for risk mitigation and management of disaster during emergencies. And then the road ahead, we are enhancing RADAR's database system because the database is growing very rapidly, and we are collaborating with the UP Department of Computer Science and developing an efficient database system for RADAR. And we need to develop a building damage function building for today. And then there are several organizations Philippine Institute of Civil Engineers and then the Association of Structural Engineers. And a great initiative or Association of Structural Engineers of the Philippines. And then we are also developing a function for casualty and bomb loss estimation. And then in the future, we intend to make the tool used by hazard simulation, which is also being able to simulate other natural hazards to touch that. So we will do it this together with our physical engineers. And then volcanic and core environmental and our simulation. And then for summary and conclusion, we have developed an extensive and user-friendly tool. And this tool is something for the local government to use. And then the use of this tool will enable the local government officials to understand and appreciate the contribution to natural hazards. And this will motivate them to do more serious damage and development. Ensure strict implementation of the results and then other ordinances to produce the government. The five-day training course also provides us a venue to download and information for them and how we will develop and fulfill other functions in the municipality. And more NGOs are very interested in using the software and they have a lot of from the government to survive in place. And if we will succeed in disseminating the system to the local government units. There is some for use, there is we see a substantial reduction in vulnerability. I think